go to share it together. The following part is the installation of the U-steel base. The most important thing in this section is to ensure the shape of the U-steel must be square and with no oblique. In addition, the groove side should be outward. Now, we will show you the welding of the U-steel base.This is the installation of the bottom board. In this section, I will give a full sight of the things which need our attention. Pay attention that the incline hole side should be placed outwards. Now, we are showing the installation of the first rubber strip.Pay much attention that there should leave some spare length of the rubber strip in case it is too short. Now, it is time for placing the washers. First, place the washers on the two sides to keep the two panels fastened. Then, place other washers accordingly. After the installation of the bolts and nuts, use the compressor gun to fasten the nuts. Don't make it too tight. Next, we will install the second rubber strip. Please follow the following steps like the engineer does. First, put the bolts through the washer and the hole. Then, place the rubber strip on the bolts. Then, put the two panels together. Let the bolts go through the other panel. Next, fix the nuts on. Next, cut off the spare parts of the rubber strip. There should be 4 to 5 millimeters length left. Now, place the rubber strip. Make sure the length of this rubber strip should be 2 times of the former 2 rubber strips. This rubber strip should also leave some spare length of 4 to 5 centimeters. Now we are making holes for the outlet flange. Then, making holes for the outlet flange on the bottom board. Now, our engineer is adjusting the flange. He is drawing the places on the panel where we should make the holes. Before install the flange, the bolts should be added with the washer and the rubber ring. And the flange should also be installed with the rubber ring. Please notice the direction of the bolts and nuts. When fastening the bolts, please make the flange stable by this spanner. Now, we are going to reverse the bottom board. In this process, be careful and keep false uniformity in case breaking the flange and the bottom board. Now, we are going to install the fixed angle iron. Then, install the other angle iron in the diagonal direction. Now we begin to welding the fixed angle iron. These holes are made for supporting the bottom board. Now we have finished the installation of the board support. Next, we are going to install the set board. The installation of the set board is similar with the bottom board. The difference is that we need the auxiliary angle iron between the set panels. Pay attention that the less hole side should be upwards. Before the installation of the sideboard, we must ensure that the bottom board have all been installed the rubber strip. Now, we will cut off the spare length of the rubber strip. Pay attention to the cutting directionsand leave 1 centimeter length. It is time to install the auxiliary angle iron. Pay attention to the directions of the bolts and nuts. Do not mix the directions. Then we will cut off the rubber strip. Keep 3 to 4 millimeters left. The same as the bottom board, we need another rubber strip whose length is 2 times than the panel's length. Now, cut off the rubber strip. Now, we are going to place the rubber strip. Make the 2 end boards go through the strip and put other boards gently go through the strip. Now we begin to stand the setboard. The engineer is adjusting the bolts on the two sides. Please pay attention. There is only one washer used on the bolts on the auxiliary angle arm. Because the installation process of every sideboard are the same, we only show you one of them. Now we will remove the board support. Now, the engineer is going to make holes for the inlet flange. This is the installation process of the inlet flange.Next is the installation of the other set board. We will not show you the details. In this process, pay attention to the direction of the boards. Please remember that don't cut off the rubber strip on the bottom board. Cut them after the installation of the whole water tank.Now, our water tank has been installed 3 sides. Only 1 side hasn't been installed. Pay more attention of the direction when cutting off the rubber strip. This is the installation of half of the last sideboard. Keep the rubber strip long enough. Now we begin to install the leaking stoppage. We cut the rubber strip into several pieces to help install the water leaking stoppage. Cut off the rubber strip as the engineer does. This is the preparation work for the leaking stoppage. Before we started, we must clean the surface of the board using a brush. Please notice the cutting direction of the rubber strip. After the preparation is done, we begin to paint the silicone. This is the inset stoppage of the water tank. Now we begin to make the outside stoppage. When making outside stoppage, someone should hold the boards by a spanner inside. When the iron patch is slightly distorted, stop fastening. This is the water stoppage work. Now we are going to paint the silicone on the iron patches on the stoppage point in case of any leaking possibility. Now, one stoppage has been done. This is the stoppage on the bottom board. Pay attention that the direction of the iron patch is different from the other patches. Now, we begin to paint the silicone on every cross. Now, we are going to prepare the timepiece installation. First, we will make the holes for the timepiece. Now, we are making holes for the outlet flange. Now, be ready to install the outlet flange. These are the bolts for the outlet flange. It should be matched with the rubber string. Now, we are going to install the top board. The top board does not need a rubber strip. Half of the top board has been finished. Now, we are going to install the tie piece and support. The normal installation sequence is to install the side door, then the top door. The engineer goes into the water tank from the manhole to install the tie piece and the support. Well, due to the limited space, we will change the installation sequence. Now is the installation of the tie piece. First, the engineer installs the external part of the tie piece through the holes we have made before. Now, we begin to install the internal part of the tie piece. Now, we will fix the tie piece. Next, we are going to install the support. The middle of the support should be fixed on the tie piece.This is the last setboard installation process. Now, we are going to install the overflow flange. This is the internal structure of the water tank. Now, our engineer is pointing out the stoppages of one side of the water tank. The whole water tank has 8 leaking stoppages. Next, we will install the manhole. It has been mentioned that all the balls should be matched with 2 washers. Only the auxiliary angle iron has 1 washer. Now is the installation of the outside ladder.